Greetings. How many times have you heard a Muslim try to assert the following as proof Jesus is not God? Jesus said God is greater than I, so Jesus is not God. It seems they completely ignore the other things Jesus said. John 10:30, I and the Father are one. John 12:45, and whoever sees me sees the one who sent me. And I am sure in a Muslim's mind, Christians are blind because we seem to ignore that God is greater. So is the only alternative to trumpet one concept and ignore the other? Those who might think so lose out on the message God has revealed. We really only have a chance at a full grasp of the revelation of God when we respect all that He has inspired by His Holy Spirit. How then do we resolve a seeming inconsistency or contradiction in two such simple statements? For the Father is greater than I and the Father are one. The truth is found in harmonizing the two revelations about God. Toward that end, we must, first of all, remain faithful to the text. And tragically, that is something Islam just never does. And that is not an idle or unsupportable slur against Islam. One need only examine the actual text of John 14:28. John 14:28, you heard me say to you, I am going away and I will come to you. If you loved me, you would have rejoiced because I am going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. Notice that Jesus does not say the word God. As Jesus does the majority of the time, Jesus says Father. In this case, Jesus does not say God or Yahweh, and not a snowball's chance he said Allah. And yet, Muslims will change the text and invent the saying, Jesus said God, God, God is greater than I. Christians, pray for the Muslims you share with. They know Jesus meant God when Jesus said Father, but they submit to the demon in their ear saying, Allah is no Father, even as they change Father to God. Ephesians 6:12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, not against Muslims, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Always remember, we must love Muslims just like God loved us before we became acceptable by His blood. Romans 5:8, but God demonstrates His own love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Muslims need the truth, the same as any lost soul. Muslims are sincere and committed to the stories they have been told. How much more will they be witnesses for the truth when they finally learn of God's great love? The simplicity of the jihad is the following. Greater than means not equal, which means not the same. That simplicity is the source of the appeal of this argument within Islam. Algebra is Arabia's greatest contribution to human civilization, with concepts greater than and equals within that contribution. So Muslims think they have a death grip on the concepts involved with their oversimplified mathematical proof. But the analogy is a total failure, perhaps as bad as imagining and choosing to follow an Allah that must fit numerical oneness. The real question, however, is whether two elements within a larger whole may exist in a state of inequality. let us first clearly state the intellectually stilted Islamic approach that boils down to a trivial, oversimplified, three-step argument. Jesus said God is greater. Therefore, Jesus is not equal, not the same. Therefore, Jesus is not God. This is literally the level of sophistication foisted as proof in Islam's sphere of influence. But I believe there may be a very good example which may open the door by a crack and let in some light of truth. Can two elements within a larger whole exist in a state of inequality? Absolutely. And one need look no further than their own body. Most people have a dominant side, right or left, right-handed or left-handed. In fighting and MMA, this distinction of fighting left-hand dominant is called southpaw. Basketball players shoot three-point shots with one particular hand and not the other. Though they may strive to achieve as much equality with floor skills like dribbling. But they would easily be described as having a greater right hand or left hand. Same person, same body, with one portion of their whole body greater in ability than another symmetrical portion. DNA would be the same, right or left. If the right hand commits murder, both hands are convicted and sentenced. One side, having greater capabilities, does not make the other a separate person. So, how then might this apply to Jesus and his relationship to his Father? First, there is another aspect to consider. Timing. Imagine someone who is right-handed, and they are injured in a car crash, and their right arm is broken, shattered, placed in a cast for 6 months. During their recovery, their right arm is immobile, useless, and they must learn to use their left arm. The left arm will gain proficiency, but will likely not reach the same capabilities as the right arm during those few months. But during the incapacitation of their right arm, they would be truthful to say, "My left arm is greater." Though at some future time, their right arm would be healed and would begin rehabilitation. The right arm would potentially be returned to its former glory and ability and power. So to be clear, part of a whole may be a dominant member of that whole. This does not imply a separation, but an asymmetry. The two are still parts of one whole, but because they are individually identifiable, they may have a relationship that is accurately described with terms like greater than. And this relationship may shift with time or context and the situation. My right hand is much better at holding a tennis racket than my left hand. My left foot is complete rubbish holding a racket. So my right hand is greater than my left hand, which is greater than my left foot for tennis. But my right foot is superior to my right hand when I play soccer. So Jesus says the Father, meaning God, is greater than I, meaning Jesus. Christians have no issue accepting that as accurate and true at the time that Jesus said it. When Jesus said it, Jesus was incapacitated. Jesus had laid aside, had emptied himself of his glory. Philippians 2:6. This is speaking of Jesus, who, although he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God a thing to be grasped or held on to, but emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being made in human likeness. Jesus emptied himself, laid aside his glory, his power, his knowledge, all that made him God. And just as Jesus was nearing the end of his mission, about to return to heaven after his resurrection from the dead, Jesus prayed the following, John 17:5, "Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was." So Christians have no issue believing Jesus was less than God when Jesus walked the earth in the flesh as a prophet. Christians have no issue believing God was greater than Jesus during this time, and Jesus was still God come to the earth in the flesh. Just as your right arm in a cast is less than your left arm that still works, until the appointed time when the right arm is healed and is restored to its position. Two parts of one body, of the same DNA and same entity, but subject to comparison that may change with time. John 10:30, "I and the Father are one." Yes, the same DNA, the same God, but two uniquely identifiable aspects. "For the Father is greater than I." Yes, when Jesus said that, Jesus had emptied his deity and accepted a subordinate position and relationship. "I and the Father are one. For the Father is greater than I." No contradiction, no confusion. When one seeks knowledge and understanding in respect for God and His Word. I hope and pray you now understand an example that might clarify and harmonize this mathematical confusion about God. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.